Hi, I'm Scott Thompson.
And welcome to Postmortem.
I love being on Hannibal, but let's face it, my character Jimmy Price is not exactly the most important guy in the show. But I found a way to remedy that. I've hijacked Hannibal's office to give myself more screen time. Oh, and of course to talk about the show, because apparently that's why we're all here. Today on Postmortem, we're talking to Will Graham himself, Hugh Dancy. We're ready for you, Mr. Dancy. So, how did you get involved in the show?
How did I get involved? I just got a call, went and had tea with Brian Fuller, read the first script of the first season, and I thought, okay, why would they want to do this? Brian is very persuasive, very charming, generous, open. He kind of made a very good case as to why this would be a good TV show.
Right.
And by the end of it, I was doing that thing where you try and pretend that you're not as interested as you secretly are.
Yeah.
And I went away thinking, well, I hope that works out.
Will's actually the main character. I mean,
I think it felt like that. It felt like that more in the first season.
Yes, it did.
And in particular because Will was less known.
How's the audience going to relate to this guy that's not connecting in a way to people around him?
I'd tell you what I realized like halfway through the first season is that Will works if you see him killing people in his head, so you know what he has to deal with, and you see him at home like with his dogs.
With his dogs.
So that humanizes him, and the other thing shows you what he's carrying around on his shoulders the whole time. Otherwise, he's just a prick.
So that was what made your decision about not looking in other people's eyes.
Well, so I think what he's done is, in order to protect himself, is that he's consciously adopted a whole load of behavior that is actually somewhat like the behavior of somebody who is on the autistic spectrum down the other end. But he's chosen it rather than you know, it being a part of him.
So it's almost like a way to protect himself.
It's exactly what
like a helmet over his senses.
Yes, exactly.
Wow. When we first started, I mean, I was terrified.
You guys,
I was terrified of Lawrence. I mean, yes. I mean, come on, we all are. You not so much because you were so charming right away. I knew I could take you in a brawl. And you knew that you could take me down.
Right, I mean, that's what I had assumed up until now. Well, I'm a little younger than those guys. I haven't had the work they've had.
And you're British.
Yeah, and I'm British. How does that...
Well, that puts me at ease.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Danes make me uncomfortable.
It turns out, yeah.
So this room, what does this room mean to you?
This room means a lot of something that I absolutely love, which I think is... unique to our show, which is what we're doing, but sitting directly opposite another actor, in this case, obviously Mads, just knocking Brian's dialogue back and forth.
Right.
And I love that. We come in to block the scene, and it's this. And then it's all about the words and finding the, you know, the small progressions within the scene that it takes a while to discover and just acting with it.
This is where I come and take a nap. This is the room that I will come in on the last day and steal something.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. Thank you very much for tuning in to Postmortem with Hugh Dancy.
Thank you. Thank you.
See you next time.